Hello, my name is Debbie. Welcome to Logical Imagination's training snippet on accounting versus currency formatting in Excel. Let's get started. First, I'm going to enter some data, and I'm specifically entering numbers of varying lengths, as well as some negative numbers and some zero values. This will help you see the visual differences between the two number formatting options that we're discussing today. Most people take the shortest route to formatting their numbers to add dollar signs, and that is highlighting the numbers that you want to format, and then selecting the dollar sign located in the number group on the Home tab. Notice when I hover over this icon, it is technically called the Accounting Number Format. By clicking the Accounting option, my January numbers now have the accounting format applied. Watch what happens when I widen that column. Notice that the accounting format aligns the dollar signs at the left edge of the cell, and it adds an extra space between the value and the right edge of the cell. Negative numbers are displayed in parentheses, and zero values are displayed with a simple dash. But there's a second option called currency. To use it, highlight the numbers that you want to format and select the drop-down list in the number group on the Home tab. By selecting the currency option, my February numbers now have the currency format applied, and watch what happens when I widen that column. Notice that the currency format aligns the dollar signs at the left edge of the number rather than the cell, and there is no extra space between the value and the right edge of the cell. Negative numbers are not displayed in parentheses, but they have a negative symbol, and zero values are displayed with an actual zero. Now, these may seem like minor differences, but some people feel passionate about one format over the other. Personally, I prefer accounting, but you can decide for yourself.